Today we are having ourselves a look at something that I would recommend to everyone. Having a storage room filled with food and other stuff. But before we enter, as you can see, there's a first aid kit. And most people ask me what's up with the rope that's hanging down from there. Well, you can never tell if someone who can't walk needs this first aid kit, so you can just grab the rope and it will fall down. But what if it hits you on the head? Well, believe me, if you're on the ground and you need to pull the rope, then you don't mind getting hit on the head anymore, so... And also, just some regular instructions for first aid. Also couldn't be checking cooking potatoes. But now, the most important part. What's inside? We're going to work ourselves through all of this. Starting from the bottom with a lot of water and a bit of oil, two bottles, because you never know when you need them. Also a lot of toilet paper. And no, I did not start hoarding it when Corona struck. I also had this stuffed when years ago when I was moving into this apartment. Stuff to make fire, because you never know, like a small cooker, lots of matches. A load of noodles, because dry noodles should actually never go bad. Can't imagine they would ever go bad. Oats, loads of oats, because you never know. This small storage area over there with the peanuts, I'm most likely going to stuff with other nuts too. But for now, just this 1 kilo bag. Something to go with the noodles, because, well, you don't want to eat dry noodles with nothing. Multiple kilos of sugar and flour, including honey, and something that would be, oh, what would be the English word for that? Damn. It's basically also just from a beet, a sweet beet. I have no idea if there's an English word for that. Of course there is, but then coffee, different kinds, and tea, different kinds, because just in case you don't want to drink your chlorified water, plain as it is. A load of different spices, because you also don't want to eat plain stuff, even if you just have to eat simple meals. Everything should be shelf stable forever, like the salt, there should be never an issue with salt. Then we work ourselves from the bottom down. As you can see, MREs and other military rations that I just keep for now because I don't know where to stuff them else. Bread in a can, it should also be shelf stable forever. A little bit of fruit, because at one point I think you will need vitamins. No, there will be no vitamins in canned fruit, so. But just to add to the stuff. Here we have a load of meat, and what the heck is going on outside right now? A load of meat, because who doesn't like meat? The corner there will be used for fish produce, but currently there's only a few cans, because oh, I like to eat tuna. Then the lowest part with the most heavy stuff, canned vegetables, all in order. This should get me through, I don't know how long, especially with all the other stuff added that's still here. There's some vinegar in the small corner between the water bottles. A whole load of rice, because rice is filling as frick, so this should help me. And some potatoes, I'm most likely going to fill up the gaps between these two with more potatoes and or more rice. And also just some batteries, because you never know when you need a battery. So this is just the prepper chamber. Most of these things basically come together from all the leftovers that I get from buying stuff. So it's no problem to fill up some of this just from the side, and the rest was on a whim. I'll just take it. It should not go bad. Oh, and as I like, see here, a whole stack of flameless ration heaters, all from MIEs. I'm going to order some new ones. But just an overlook. Maybe you can get an idea from that to stack up yourself.